their parents had to be there. So why didn't their parents say something? What's up, everybody? I wanted to say hello. I uploaded one video last week talking about Logan. I uploaded a video recently, though. I haven't uploaded since. I feel bad that I haven't uploaded since. I just haven't had time to just do it. Work has been crazy, and personal life has been crazy. Today, I wanted to really take the time. I'm coming back from North Georgia. Look at this photo. I mean, this thing is like, it's beautiful out of here. This was like this really windy road. There was just this amazing view of the mountains, and the clouds are really low. It just looked nice. I had to take that picture. I want to do a filler vlog real quick. Today, we're going to talk about the whole H&M controversy. Okay, about the whole H&M controversy. Now, if you haven't heard about it, take a look at this photo here. That photo is the photo that everyone is complaining about because it is, of course, an African-American child and what the shirt says. Now, I've seen a lot of people talking about it. I saw LeBron James make a whole post about it, and I saw a few other people, Plaz, he made a post about it saying, like, he wouldn't buy their clothes ever again. I don't feel that it was done intentionally. And I feel that a lot of steps were missed in stopping it. So let me first say that what I mean by it wasn't done intentionally is basically, do you really think H&M bought that one shirt or designed that one shirt with the monkey saying on it and then went out and found the one kid that they wanted and found the black kid and did this photo shoot? No, that works. They most likely had multiple designs and probably multiple kids, and they were probably having each kid just change into a different shirt and take a picture. So they may have had 10 outfits for this kid to try on. He tried on all 10 outfits. One of them was that outfit. It wasn't necessarily H&M trying to do something like that. It was, they released a whole statement on Instagram. That's right here. And first of all, I don't buy from the company, so it doesn't really matter to me at all. I won't boycott somebody over something like that. I don't feel, that's not something intentional, in my opinion. Now, what was intentional was Publix, which is a company that I hate. I'll get into that on a later video. They deliberately donated over $1 million, or right at $1 million, to a company to try to stop marijuana legalization for medical purposes in Florida. So yeah, that's why I say Publix, because I can't stand them, and they're one of the companies in the world. And I will do a whole filler vlog on why they are the company in the world when I need another filler vlog. But either way, what I wanted to say was that I don't feel that this was done on purpose. There's multiple steps to this process. Process one is the shirt had to be designed. Process two was the actual photo shoot. Now again, I would almost guarantee, and I don't know any of this for facts, but I would guarantee that H&M likely had 10 kids at this photo shoot. And they also likely had 100 different outfits for these kids to try on. And it was probably, you don't even know if it's a thing of it goes in order. So it could have just been that they do shirts 1 through 10 and they do shirts 11 through 20. And if shirt number 11 was that shirt and that kid happened to get done with his photo shoot first, then bada bing, he's the one putting that shirt. Not because it was black, not because of any of that, but that's what everyone nowadays tries to take stuff and twist it and turn it into to make a big deal out of it. And really, I don't feel it should be a big deal at all. Again, I don't know anything about the company. Here's how that I looked at it. The kid looked like he was, what, 5 years old? If I'm not mistaken, their parents had to be there. So why didn't their parents say something? Why didn't their parents look at their kid and go, oh no, I don't want you to wear this shirt because of this and this? Because their parents were looking at it from the same point of view that I look at it, and the same point of view that a handful of people look at it, and it's that it was a job. The kid was there to do a job, that was it. He went in to do his job, and that happened to be the shirt that he was given. I don't believe there was a single person at H&M going, oh, look at this shirt, we're definitely going to make sure we get that to a black kid. I'm not saying that that's not around anymore. That is 100% still around. There's still a lot of racism in America. But I just don't feel that that was the intention here, especially with a clothing company like that that's that big, that's a big name, that already probably had a lot to do that day. That's my take on it. I find it all a little crazy. Like I said, I've heard a lot of people are boycotting and this and that, and I don't understand it. I don't think it was done on purpose. And obviously, what you also have to think about is that not only did the parents not notice, and the parents didn't say anything, the photographer didn't think anything about it. You don't know if the photographer was white or black. Who knows? That's not including everyone else. That there's people that edited that photo that had to make the ads and go to put that photo on the website. There's a lot of people that this photo went by, and nobody thought a thing about it. And all it took was the one person to go, oh my God, it's a black kid in a shirt that says monkey on it, and they flipped out about it, and now they've caused this whole thing, and it's all over the internet. Either way, my video is going to go up today, because, I mean, if everyone else is going to talk about it, I might as well talk about it too. It's not me trying to stay like in the times or copy anyone. Let me make that very, very clear. My filler vlogs are more so giving my point of view and what that I see. If I see that I think everything's wrong with the situation, that's what I'm going to say. In this situation, I just feel that it was just kind of a misunderstanding circumstance. This has been like way longer than my normal filler vlog, so I'm going to go ahead and cut this video, relax for like an hour and a half, and then go get her laundry and do a bunch of dad stuff. So I hope everyone, though, has a great day. I definitely hope that I didn't offend anybody with this. Wasn't trying to, of course. Quite frankly, don't care if I did. But it's my point of view on it, is what that I see on it. And that's all that I'm sharing, just like I would do in a Facebook post, just like I would do in anything else. So, hope you guys and gals have a great day, and